stick shifts and safety belts. Bucket seats have all got to go when we're driving in the car.
I lust after a nice Lancer Evo or a WRX STI, 300 horsepower, all-wheel drive, just slinging that little thing through twisties in the middle of nowhere. Oh, that would be so sweet. The reality is that the roads that fill our nation, the roads that fill our lives, are pretty dull. But the joy of driving on a beautiful little road is gone. That dream of the freedom of the automobile has become a nightmare of enslavement to it. Our addiction to the car has fragmented us as a nation and isolated us as a nation. How long's your commute? How long do you have to drive to get to work? To get to church? To get to the places you need to go in your life? How much of those brief moments that God has given you do you spend behind the wheel? And does that feel healthy to you? Does that feel like a good thing?
I need you here with me.
The goodness of God's creation is sealed away from us. We are separate from it. We run and drive on roads that are great blackened veins of death across our country, where nothing lives. Nothing can live. Little strips of blackened desert, pulsing with steel like veins across the formerly fertile lands of this nation. Is that the way we care for creation? Do you ever just look at the highway and see what an unnatural thing it is? Can we really say that this is part of what God wants for our world? That this way of living is natural or good?
The land of race car yayas.
That's just about all.
The land of race car yayas. Race car yayas.